Okay, so these are the FXR coats and stuff. And I've been planning on getting a new coat since I got the new sled 2 years ago. But I'm not crazy about the designs Skidoo has out right now. So, yeah, I'm looking at other brands, but nothing has exactly caught my eye just yet. But I kind of like the simplicity of the coat I've had since 2010. You know, just says Skidoo across the front. But, you know, I'm open to other designs and other brands. As long as it's not another brand of snowmobile. Let me know what you think. So, like, these designs here I think are way too flashy. Not my style. Honestly, I like the stuff that, you know, Shag Gary and my brother Zook are wearing, but they've already got those and they're not current things you can buy anyway. Plus, we don't want to look like a race team with all the same gear on anyway.
Those are size 12.
But, you know.
Yeah.
These are quite nice, just too flashy for me. Climb has some nice looking stuff too, but it's really going to have to catch my eye and make me want to actually bite the bullet and buy a new coat. It doesn't say Skidoo on it. Here we go. We go hunting with this one. So this is Caliber's version, I would say, of the Super Clamp. Looks quite robust, and we're gonna get a little demonstration here by one of the Caliber reps.
So you just basically click it down this way, and then ours, compared to the Super Clamp, is a little different because ours is on the side here. It's
gotcha.
Also adjustable up and down this way in case you have higher or lower skis.
Right.
And it comes with a lifetime warranty as well.
Okay. And I see your pin here.
Yep.
Let me see. Put that in. I noticed when you actually try to clip it in, it just kind of works its way down, so you don't have to pull it out.
Correct.
Or anything. It snaps in real easy, and then when you want to release it, you pull on it and it comes right off.
Yep. And then it just
now, how do you adjust the height?
To be honest, you just kind of spin it right
Oh,
here.
Okay.
Yep.
So this left screw adjustment here controls the depth of the hook.
Yes. And ours is called the Clamp Pro.
Clamp Pro.
Yeah.
So from Caliber.
Show it to you.
There you go. Perfect. All right, I see a shot of the bottom of it. Very nice.
Don't get my nails in there.
No problem.
They're all broken from setup, unfortunately. All right.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, no problem.
Okay, and that retails for $299 Canadian. If you're interested, look it up. Here's the info. And she gave me for all their new products here, but specifically the Clamp Pro. Here's a shot of the Expedition hooked up to a covered toboggan. Yeah, quite the storage capabilities here.
Nice.
Quick shot of this Scandic. So this has like 900 ace motor, super wide skis, humongous trunk.
Hey Tim?
Looks like a 20 inch at least wide track. It's insane. Yeah. And then it's got the 7.2 inch gauge on it, or display, if you will. And I don't even know what you would call this body style. It's gonna be some type of Gen 4. Yeah, there's the specs.
You are sled.
Depending on how many ride on.
Canadian price.
Yeah.
I'm gonna come right up to it. All right, here we are checking out the Lynx sleds. So 24 Rave RE. I don't know if you can read those specs with the glare. So you turn on the light. Maybe you can make that out. These are Canadian prices, of course. So we'll just get some close-ups so you can take a look, and then we'll check out the X-Terrain. To the X-Terrain, because Grim Reaper there wanted to see something about it. So this has got the adjustable windshield on it. So this is not going to be detailed specs, but at least it's going to be some close-ups of what the things actually look like on the sled. Of course, the 2024 X-Terrain RE. Picture 3700, which I believe is the 144. Picture of the dash. It's got the 10 1/4 inch display. This is the new control that they came out with last season. Got a hand grab there. It's a two stroke. 91 octane, and this has the new system for the Lynx, the B-Link. Shorter seat, narrow frame there, so you can get in real tight on the sled. It's got toe holds and foot holds down here. So we take a look at the track. It's a pretty good lug paddle there. And obviously room for two accessories. Take a look under here. Shot from behind. And it has a pull cord on this. Not sure if it has electric start. We can look at the specs again. Let's get a shot here of the X-Terrain. So, features. It's electric and manual start, so it comes with both, or at least this one has it. Looks like it's standard though, by the way it's built into the cover there, so looks like it comes with both. Start and electric start. All right, hope that does it for you, buddy. Backcountry Adrenaline 600R with a 146. KYB shocks. Small gauge. New hand control. Kill switch. It's got standard RCA jack for the heated shield, and then you have color mode. Apparently, I'm not familiar with what that is. There you go.
Oh yeah,
Adrenaline. the specs on this drone backcountry. Deco power. So that's got a nice wrap on it. What's this say? Crafted and engineered. Optimized engine size, horsepower, range, modification level, and riding style. Deco power belt line offers the best in extreme performance for today's ATVs, XSS, and snowmobiles. This shock up.
New York and Ithaca area.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, we can do those. Yeah.
Am I supposed to take a picture?
Yeah.
I got it.
Springs.
What?
Because we're in the